How are you feeling, though?
I don't know. It's a good question. I do feel relief. I feel... Yeah, I mean, I've been holding on to these songs for, I mean, a couple years now, some of them, and it's relief, but then it's also anxiety knowing that a lot of people are about to hear things that were very personal ruminations at one point. Yeah, it's just a mind fuck. It's like, it's a lot to take in, even though it came from us, you know?
Sounds really good.
You think?
I want you guys to hear this reverb. This reverb I brought.
Oh yeah.
Just kind of over the last couple years, just kind of been collecting songs and slowly adding them to this basket, kind of not really like aiming for anything specific, but just, you know, knowing that we would get back in the studio at some point. And then when it kind of started feeling like I had something to say, we started really taking a finer look at like all the things and honing in on what those things would be. The title just came out of nowhere. Like, I just thought it would be cool to write a song called Starcrossed, and that was the last one we wrote. And then kind of was just like, what if that was the album title? Just kind of rolled from there. And then literally like 2 days later, we somehow like found a studio. Everybody was free.
Ripped right at the seams. Woke up from the perfect dream, and then the nighttime came. Signed the papers yesterday. You came and took your things away. I moved out of the home we made and gave you back your name. No one's to blame, 'cause we called all the angels to save us. No my name, but I guess they got lost. Star-crossed.
That one was a good
one. That was stunning.
I'm starting to like really kind of get up.
I like how you kind of played a little quieter and then kind of moved into like a, you kind of built.
Yeah.
That was pretty nice. We were thinking of the album like a true arc of a tragedy. So, you know, you set the scene and then there's slowly like a crescendo and like a climax of this drama between two people. There's a fallout. Oh my God, it's dramatic. And then there's the aftermath. Yeah.
Yeah, it's fun.
Amazing.
I think so that, fun.
What a great way to start.
Hell yeah. are literally like from my bed.
Try to tell y'all last year, try to tell y'all this year, but nobody listens. So I'm back to set the record straight.
Yeah, they want the, I only have some breath here. Oh,
okay. What were you saying?
I know, like, it's that, and then it goes to, like, a bro country. It just goes in a bro country song, and then we're like, y'all really thought I was going to do that? Or what? Never mind. No, not that.
Just kidding.
The studio is awesome in a matter of hours, like the album title came, the last song, which it was number 40, which is Starcross, which is obviously it's the album title, but the concept sonically materialized. It was this kind of big boom that kind of happened. It feels really serendipitous. I feel like we're all in the right place at the right time, so that feels good.
You know, at whatever time we light the candles, we sit down together,
yes,
and have a meal, and you know,
you can put it up here if you want.
I was trying to make those lights even.
Oh.
But maybe it doesn't matter. Maybe they can both fit. Oh.
Drums. The drums.
Uh-huh.
I know, I kind of think so too. I don't want them to be too good.
Yeah. I don't love that on the end of it, like mm-hmm, the... Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I can fix that.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I was just messing around with the...
Alright, well maybe this is just a little surgical time.
I hope you haven't forgotten Tokyo wasn't built in a day.
Cool.
I'm not afraid of a bite. I can take it, watch how I bend, but I'm not breaking. I've been to hell and back, golden hour faded black. Say that it ain't coming back, ain't coming back. But you're gonna feel me, you're gonna feel me.
Will you punch me right there? Yep. I might have to do verses separately. There's such a different
cool.
thing.
Nice.
Yeah.
Just the verse, or did you want the end of the chorus?
Actually, let me just tackle the first verse.
It feels like we've worked harder.
I agree.
Yeah?
I feel like that. It was a huge undertaking. I mean, my throat's been hurting. It's been very intense physically even. I feel like we've been doing a puzzle for a whole entire month. And yeah. I can't even believe a whole month has passed.
I feel like the approach for this stuff has been much more like painting, like one mm-hmm. color at a time, or making sure that like the...
It's like paint by number.
Yeah.
We had to figure out like mm-hmm. what the ins and outs of these like little sounds and like little moments are that were really important. It's chronological in like a mental way for me. The first song, Starcross, sets the scene and you kind of journey with me through like that first year of marriage and being on the road and then and really craving simplicity. You know, problems start to arise and it's a look at those. It's also self-reflection. I'm my own worst critic and there's a lot of things I know I could have done better or could do better. And so that's me kind of exploring those thoughts too. And then there's the aftermath. There's everything you're left with when something beautiful ends. It's sadness, it's anger, it's loneliness, relief, guilt, all the above. I wouldn't take it back for a second at all. I just finished recording my version of Gracias a la Vida. I actually heard whenever I was on this 7-hour guided mushroom trip recently. The song was written by this woman named Violeta Parra, and it was actually the last song she wrote in, morbidly enough, a suicide note that she left. And then it was re-recorded by Mercedes Sosa, and that's the version that I heard during this trip. And I was just absolutely impaled by it. I knew like that I wanted to do my own version of the song when I heard it to kind of pay tribute to it and to the meaning. Gracias a la vida says thank you to life, it's given me so much. Gracias a la vida que me ha dado tanto, me ha dado la risa y me ha dado el llanto. Así yo distingo dicha que pronto los dos materiales que forman mi canto y el canto de ustedes que es el mismo canto y el canto de todos que es mi propio canto. Gracias a la vida.